Good afternoon, everyone. This is Dr. Asia with you. It's an honor and privilege for me to welcome you all who are present here and connected with us virtually. On behalf of Prime Health, we are glad to launch our first Prime Personality Awards in association with our first tea with Dr. Tasneem. The concept of Prime Personality Awards, started in 2021, is built on heart it, will it, appreciate it, and repeat it. With this, we would like to appreciate and award our first Prime Personalities for their outstanding contribution to Prime Health, who are our Prime Trekkers, to Mount Kilimanjaro, of course, the world's tallest freestanding mountain, which was led by none other than Dr. Azam Badar Khan, Dr. Usha Kiran, Dr. Mahesh Kumar, and Dr. Balaji. Hold on. Just to let you know, it's not going to be only an interactive session, but yes, you will have an opportunity to win exciting prizes right after tea with Dr. Tasneem. Do not miss this chance and stay tuned. We'll be asking you simple questions. So let us begin with our first interactive session featuring tea with Dr. Tasneem. It's a great honor to invite and welcome Dr. Tasneem Jameel, our Deputy Managing Director at Prime Healthcare, to commence the first live chat with our first Prime Personalities.
Hello, Dr. Hello, Dr. Usha, please. Hello, Dr. Dr. Mahesh. Dr. Balaji, please, let's all have a seat. Good afternoon to all of you here and to the other Prime family members who are watching this event. As you all know, this is the first Prime Personality event, and I'm so happy that we could also launch the Tea with Dr. Tasneem event. Though originally planned to be hosted by me at home, due to the COVID restrictions, we were unable to go ahead. I'm glad that we could at least hold the event, even though the location is different. 2021 is the year of appreciation, and we have been seeking every opportunity to fulfill this desire. Salary refunds and the ongoing salary increments are such opportunities for appreciation, and these were planned. But sometimes an unplanned opportunity also gives us a huge sense of satisfaction. Appreciating the Prime Trekkers, such a cute name they gave themselves. It is so nice. Appreciating the fact that despite the COVID anxiety, they showed the courage to be positive and go on this expedition. Appreciating the fact that they are busy doctors who could take some time off for themselves. Appreciating the fact that they achieved what they went for and came back safely with amazing teamwork. Please join me in congratulating them. Dr. Azam leading the team, Dr. Usha, the sole lady in the group, Dr. Mahesh, and Dr. Balaji. Congratulations to you all. Thank you for joining me here. We will have a brief chat about your experiences, and I'm sure the positive messages will benefit all of us. Dr. Azam, can you tell us briefly about the trek?
It was our privilege to take this pledge to go to Kilimanjaro, ma'am. It was the Kilimanjaro is the only mountain in the world which is standing alone, and it is the highest mountain in the continent of Africa, which is at the height of
895.
Yeah, yeah.
Wow. Okay.
So that's the height of it, and which is equivalent to the base camp of Mount Everest.
Wow.
And the beauty about this is that it is being the sole standing mountain. It has different routes to it.
Okay.
It has seven routes, so that a person, depending upon his capability and fitness and time and endurance, can choose whatever route they want to.
Okay.
We had chosen the route which is called the Machami route, which is the most popular route of for the Kilimanjaro, and
which has the maximum success rate.
Okay. That has a 95% success rate, and it is called a Coca-Cola route.
No.
Whiskey root.
Okay.
Coca-Cola
okay.
is Marango.
Okay.
So, Balaji is yes, more theoretically...
Balaji is well read.
Great.
He has chosen whiskey root.
That's good.
Yeah. And then it was a good start, I mean, say, to start with. We had an impression that it is a walking mountain. And we thought that it is not going to be very tough and challenging, but it was
really challenging.
Dr. Mahesh will be able to tell us more about it because he was the one who had a certain hitch in our trek.
Okay. It was the walking, crawling, climbing, everything.
It was a great challenge.
Actually, out of the 7 summits, this is the 4th highest mountain.
Okay.
This is like walking from the equator to the North Pole in a week. You
wow,
see a distinguishing terrain every day, vegetation, okay. Animal life, terrain is changing day by day.
We are crossing five regions of the to
it's
start
like
with.
Snow mountains, the center,
okay.
Surrounded by the dry savanna region,
okay.
And then by the rainforest around it.
Okay.
So,
wow.
So
when we start,
we are trekking from the rainforest.
Okay.
So we are hardly seeing anything. It's tall trees all around the place, and we are trekking the whole day between that. The second day, it's
a dry savanna kind of thing.
Okay.
So where there you can see the dormant volcanoes.
So it was totally a 5-day trek.
7-day trek.
Okay.
5 days of going up, climb. And then 1.5 days coming down.
Okay, all right. Thank you so much, Dr. Azam. We all know that if we must achieve something extraordinary, we need to first have the passion to succeed. So, Dr. Azam, you had done Mount Everest earlier and now Mount Kilimanjaro. How did you develop this passion to scale the peak successfully?
Ma'am, I believe that life is all about passion. Whatever you do in life, you should like it, which should give you happiness.
Right.
And it's been always there in me. And I started, adventure has been in my blood. And because I believe that just being an orthopedician or a doctor is not enough in life. There is, you don't know life when it will go away. So it's a short life. I believe in that. I try to take it day by day. And so it's adventure has always been thrilling to me, and it gives me kick and it gives me happiness. Apart from, we all know that money is very important in our life, but at the same time, we have to also satisfy our inner self.
Yes. So this is the first core value of Prime, passion. Thank you, Dr. Azam.
Thank you.
Dr. Mahesh and Dr. Balaji. For you, this is the first time. What motivated you to join this expedition?
My inspiration is Dr. Azam Khan. So last year, when he went for Everest Base Camp, I was closely watching him doing and performing it. Immediately when he came back, we had a discussion. Whether is it possible for me also to do the same thing?
Okay.
And he said that definitely, why not? And then I said that I'm with you at any time when you're going for planning for next time, I'm with you.
Great, so, Dr. Mahesh. Okay, Dr. Balaji.
Actually, this pandemic has taken a toll on our mind and body. Many people are struggling with COVID-induced stress and anxiety.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay. This new normal has unleashed working hours, the social isolation, travel restrictions.
Yeah.
So all our disparities in life. So I believe and I advise these kind of nature adventures is a stress buster to it.
Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Balaji. Dr. Usha, you were the only lady among the prime trekkers, and congratulations for successfully reaching the summit. As a lady, did you have any second thoughts? I know you regretted meeting Dr. Azam halfway through the expedition.
Well, before we started the, I knew Dr. Azam only 2 weeks before we started this trek.
Okay.
I didn't even know who he was.
Okay.
And I just met him near the lift and got introduced and decided that I'll go for this trek. And before we started on the day one of the Machami trek, gate, I gave him a hug and I said, if I don't make it, I still want to remember this as that because of you, I've actually attempted to do this. Okay. But day 5 was a different story. I hated meeting him.
So it was tough, very
it
tough.
It was very tough, yeah. Okay. I mean, we all know that nature and God himself has endowed men with the physical strength much more than the women. Yeah. But I do believe that as women, we have the stronger mental ability and power, and which is very dormant in every woman that we see. That's why even in the mythology, Ma Shakti and Durga are represented as strength and power.
Yes.
And with the strength and power, we also have the endurance. I don't think any man has the endurance of a woman.
Thank you so much.
In fact, she has proved on every day that she is like a superwoman.
We clap.
Go to bed last in the group, and then she is waking up early in the morning. Everyone, amazing.
Coffee.
Thank you.
She is a she man.
I just want to say something that this endurance and power is very dormant in every woman. And it is very important that in the manly world that there are the right men in your life who actually give power to this dormant power.
Well said.
Empowering women is a man's job. And I've been fortunate to have a dad who has empowered me, a husband who has left me as I am with the same power. And I also want to thank Dr. Jamil for the head of the organization as a man to have encouraged all of us. And the five men that I was with in this trek, who really treated me like, you know, a comrade, at the same time with dignity, which was very nice.
At the same time, I have to say, without this kind of lady in our group, we could not have done this one.
Thank you.
The way she, the enthusiasm and the motivation, from day one to day five, without her support, we could have made it.
I would also like to add, ma'am, men, as she was saying, that men has been given a physical strength. Mm. But again, the women by God has been given a more mental strength, and she proved it. I'm saying, I can tell you, all of us, all men, at the end of the day, somebody or the other was having some issue,
yes,
physical, mental, but she was the one who was
right bang on it, giving us the boost of the mental boost, I'd say.
Yes. Yeah. And the brew. Okay.
So we had a coffee with Usha.
Yeah.
Coffee with Kiran.
Thank you. Fashion can lead to success only if we have quality consciousness. In an expedition under such severe conditions, lack of quality in preparing for the climb can lead to serious injuries. We are grateful to God that you all came back safe. What quality steps did you take in preparing for this expedition?
So, being a Prime member for so long, I have learned from Prime how to make the preparation for the success. From the physical preparations, I started and I have motivated and keep on putting messages and videos in the WhatsApp group to do regular physical exercise. And Dr. Azam, he arranged
that's very important.
That we did. And then I also took part in...
Doctor, you know that Dr. Mahesh is a marathon runner and he's been Berlin, Paris and all these marathons, Istanbul also.
So your physical stamina is
so
good.
So physical stamina, in fact, I used to run only. I don't have experience of climbing. So that is a different experience, and also climbing up with backpack is also a challenge.
Yeah. And that, also the oxygen level comes down.
Exercise. And also we were searching of how to prepare for the packing and what all the materials we need to take. And Dr. Azam with his travel agent, he made all the travel arrangements. But I was helping them to prepare for packing and what all the things we need to take.
Any mental preparation?
Yes, ma'am. That is what is. Just now we were talking about the. Yeah. You were talking about the oxygen level. Hmm. That is the biggest challenge when we are going on a high altitude, is the mountain sickness or what we call the altitude sickness, is the biggest challenge. And that is the basic of that has to be understood by everybody, that what, why and what happens and why people get sick. Because as we go up, the oxygen level in the environment reduces, and that causes the hypoxia and like few things, dizziness, breathing problems,
headache.
So these are few of the symptoms which happen. So basically, while we were doing the training, we could all together do few of the sessions here in the local. We are lucky that in this part of the world we have Fujairah, where we have these mountains where we could do a 3-4 hours of trek.
Okay.
So it is up and down. Okay. So basically acclimatization means that you go to a height and come down.
Yeah.
So that you are getting your body.
It's not a direct climb. Direct climb. Acclimatize.
Yes. That's very important.
This is the one of the reason why we choose Machami route.
Okay.
So this is like a climb high and a sleep low philosophy.
Right. Right.
So we have time for acclimatization at every step.
Okay. Thank you. We could see in the videos how difficult the climb was. Dr. Usha, you had a nice way of putting it across, especially the trek around the Kissing Mountain. We will watch the video.
He said, kissing the rock.
We're calling kissing rock.
We'll call it something else.
In our line of work, empathy is a very essential element. Prime Personalized Care is all about empathy and building personal relationships with our patients. You visited an orphanage to show your solidarity, and Prime also pitched in with a small contribution. It was very touching to see the kids' reaction. Can we have the video, please?
Here we are at Kilimanjaro Orphanage Center, and from the Prime Healthcare, we are donating, trying to help them, and we wish all this orphanage children best of the future. Balaji,
thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you, Prime.
Thank you.
How did you all feel?
It's a difficult thing to explain in words what I actually felt when I went into that orphanage. First of all, I've got to thank Prime for actually making us the, you know, instrument to do whatever we had to do there for those kids. And Dr. Azam to have, you know, spontaneously struck up a conversation with the guide and
found out that
there was a need for this particular thing.
Yeah.
We all know the saying goes that God made parents because he couldn't be there everywhere.
Yes.
And so parents are the form of God, actually. And to me, when I looked at those children, I felt like God just forgot about them. And what do these kids do when they don't have a parent? It's just that they have no direction, nothing. So it was very overwhelming to see that, and how fortunate we have been that, you know, having parents is the most fortunate thing that anybody can have in their lives.
Yes.
And I'm glad we were able to do something, at least for the children, if not everything.
Thank you, Dr. Usha. Thank you. I was getting goosebumps when I saw you all raising the Prime flag at the summit. It was a very touching gesture, especially since all of you went in your personal capacity. Thank you for exhibiting one of our most important core values, ownership. Can you please describe this?
Let's start, Dr. Mahesh.
It was a wonderful experience for me. So I have been with Prime since 2005. So I never imagined that I am going to
have completed 15 years with
more
Prime.
Than
15, 16 years.
Loyal member
more
of
than
Prime.
15. And then I never imagined that I am going to hoist the flag at Mount Kilimanjaro. So God made us this possible. So I was very much impressed, and I was very proud to hoist the flag in Mount Kilimanjaro.
Dr. Balaji.
Yes, actually, if you know, Kilimanjaro is a continent inspired for freedom. That was the first African nation to get free from the colonial powers. So the summit, Uhuru Peak, is in Swahili, it means freedom.
Freedom, okay.
Freedom.
Actually, ma'am, the hosting the flag, as you are aware, that I have done it before also for the Prime, and I'm privileged to you and Dr. Jameel that you've always given me this freedom and privilege that I can whatever endeavors I take, I can do that. That was last time, it was on the Mount Everest base camp. And apart from that, if you remember last year, in Kargil also, I had taken the flag where I had done a free knee camp. And I'm supposed to doing a few knee replacement surgeries there also. Thank you very much for giving me this platform and encouragement. And every time when I take the flag, I take it with passion, and Prime is like...
with ownership, Dr. Azam.
Yes, thank you very much for putting that word to me. And trust me, it is like ownership. I don't see anything apart from Prime, at least in this part of the world, no. I have already told my family that if I have to leave Dubai, it'll be out of Prime, I'll be going back to India.
Thank
otherwise,
you've stolen my line. That's what I told her. Thank you.
Well, can so,
we,
so
have, the, can
like
we have the video of the flag hoisting, please? Thank you.
Hi, Dr. Azamuddin Khan, a specialist orthopedic surgeon in Prime Hospital. Here we bring the message from Prime Healthcare Group with a team of doctors to the top of Africa, which is Kilimanjaro. Prime Healthcare Group is one of the leading healthcare providers in UAE, and our motto is personalized care personally. So we are going out of the boundary of UAE, and we are not just limiting ourselves to UAE, and we have decided and we are spreading the message out of the boundary to international borders. And here we are in Africa with a motto of trek to Kilimanjaro for charity. We have adopted an orphanage in a small town near Kilimanjaro from where we have started our trek, and we'll be donating and we'll be visiting there. So this whole trek is for charity, and if God willing, inshallah, we'll be doing this kind of activity on a regular basis. So here we are, my orthopedic surgeon of healthcare group, Dr. Jameel and Dr. Tasneem, our mentors. We thank them that they have supported us to reach the top of Africa, which is Kilimanjaro. Three cheers, Africa and Prime Healthcare.
Okay, start. Woohoo! One team!
One dream!
One team!
One dream!
All the way! Where are we now?
We made it!
Uhuru Peak! We made it!
Finally, success is only achievable if there is teamwork. Some of us are very good, some need support. Some of us need motivation, and some are self-motivated. Teamwork, again, a very important Prime core value. Can you please let us know what teamwork was for you all in the successful expedition?
Teamwork was there in every step of the day we started off.
Okay.
I mean, none of us knew each other very well. I knew only Dr. Balaji in the OT, and rest of us were all very, you know, bit of a stranger. We started off with Dr. Azam, Dr. Balaji and Dr. Mahesh. After 2 days, we were on first name basis. On the fifth day, we were on Bala Shaitan Kasara. But so the bonding that happened in the 5 days was extraordinary. I tell them that they are friends for life for me.
Right.
And we did everything together, apart from sleeping together, we did everything together. And we were sharing socks. we were giving neck massages to each other.
Okay.
So it was like each person's and different personalities actually contributed in different ways. Mahesh with his precision, Dr. Azam with his leadership, Balaji with his enthusiasm, me with my conviction.
So I can say that first two days, we were making understanding of ourselves.
Okay.
The pace of each individual different, and the guide also, he found it little difficult to coordinate for first 2 days. After discussion each night, after finishing that, before starting the next day, and then from third day, all are on the same pace.
Right.
And it was wonderful that we could achieve, and the guide for this tour program, he was also excellent. And the core two concept he was using is that slow and steady.
Slow pole,
and
pole.
Keep
slow
telling
and steady.
That pole pole.
Yeah.
Even someone who has the capacity is going fast, he will pull down.
Yes.
And
okay.
Go slow and steady.
Right.
And he never allowed us to break.
Okay.
So slow and steady and constant pace.
And all together, there's
all
no one
together.
Left behind.
Yeah.
Okay.
And he was telling one more important key word is that Hakuna Matata.
Yes, that is made famous by Lion
very, very
Hakuna
famous, yes.
Matata. That means that
no problem.
You,
no,
no problem,
no worries,
no worries.
No worries.
No
you won't encounter any problem. And then he was keep telling, that was motivating like anything when we are falling sick or falling ill.
Yeah.
It was motivating like anything. We
yeah.
could finish
and
off
all
that
of you
day
together. That's the most important
yeah,
thing.
Yeah,
as
you are talking
yeah,
about the
teamwork. Yeah.
Teamwork is especially for these kind of, otherwise in your common life also teamwork is always important. But especially these kind of endeavors when we are taking where we are in isolation, where
yeah.
we are not expecting any help. And we are on our own, then teamwork really comes into play a very important role. And as Dr. Mahesh is saying, that it takes one or two days to get into it, but once you realize your the platform that where you are, and then you start forgetting your egos or your negativity or anything, and then you start dealing
it's
with
common
other
destination, common, you see
common,
the common
destination, and you have to intermingle.
We had a slogan. We had a slogan. One team, one dream.
One team, one dream.
One
team,
one
dream.
Dream.
Yeah. Thank you.
We can repeat it. I think
yes,
the way we were doing it.
One team, one
dream.
One team,
one dream.
One dream.
Excellent.
And I have to say, Dr. Azam has been the best leader for this group.
Thank
it takes
you.
The leader to...
I think we clap.
Yes, yes.
It takes a leader to know when to stay back with... He was staying back with the slowest person.
Okay.
And he was making sure that everybody was, you know, fine. At the same time, you know, looking after and tolerating everybody and bringing the group together. And he does definitely have leadership skills.
Thank you.
Because
thank
apart
you,
from
thank
the pole pole, we had a polar polist.
We as a prime team are at closest to the Kilimanjaro on our third day of trek. This is the first moment we have come very close. And Kilimanjaro is right behind us. I'm sorry, the cloud is again coming all the way around. And as you can see,
there is a stream of water running from the melting glacier.
Who's Kusha?
Kushne, I'm enjoying it.
Okay, Balaji is back up again in his mood. So can you do some dance, Balaji?
Full spirit, Hakuna Matata.
Okay. Bye, Prime.
Yay.
Personalized care personally.
Personalized care personally.
Thank you. Bye bye.
Thank you.
you everyone for being here.
Thank you.
We will have the question answer session now for everyone watching. Dr. Asia will be conducting it. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Dr. Tasneem, for giving us this platform and letting us, giving us the opportunity.
And honoring us.
Honoring us.
Yes, appreciating you. You are prime personality first winners.
Thank you.
We are privileged. Thank you.
We would like to felicitate our prime personalities with a certificate and a gift. Dr. Azam, thank you. This is something for you.
Thank you very much.
Dr. Usha,
thank you very much.
This is something for you. Dr. Mahesh,
thank you.
Dr. Balaji.
Thank you.
Join me for tea.